Hey, hello, drone family, wherever you are, I wish you well. And I don't even matter the vendor of your drone. Drone family, wherever you are. Today on my channel, I'm going to be talking about why do we crash drones? I've been thinking about that. Luckily for me, I got 3D skills. So you see, I got my little 3D rendering, my little 3D sketch right here. Some little simple trees and a simple person right here. And this camera, and here's my little simple drone right here too. My little drone. I may try to move my drone. I'm gonna see. But anyway, why do we crash? Here's one reason why right now. I'm gonna click on my drone. I'm gonna click on my human. Click on his camera, and go to his camera, and we're gonna take a look. Camera, active camera. All right, now my person. Now we get to see the whole thing. Let me see what I can do here. Okay, now you see my person right here. We'll be able to look from side to side. That give us some idea of, depth of field. And my person is moving too. He's moving with the camera. I'm gonna keep walking with him if I can. I just can go from side to side, but you see when I can move around, that helps me with my depth of field. That helps with my depth of field right there. So, in the 3D world, we have some awareness of depth perception. Depth perception that we have. All right, so that's my. I'm gonna go back to. Let me see if I can look through my drone now. Front. Here's my little drone. Let me see if I can get the camera for my drone. Right here, here's my camera for my drone. And I'm gonna see if I can set that as an active. View, camera. So now I'm looking through my drone, because we see the drone body here. I'm gonna move my drone around. Now, when we look into the drone, you see how it looks now. When I have my camera, I'm still looking through my drone. My drone's still moving. But I can see the world, but it may not be completely 3D when I look through my drone. When we're looking through our phone, this is how the world looks when we have our phone. Right there. Right, this is how the world looks through our phone. It looks flat and two-dimensional. This is my camera route. Looking through my phone, this is how the world looks. I don't see no depth of field. Because earlier when we was watching, we knew it was a lot of space between this point and here. But now since I'm watching the route through my camera, my depth of field gone. Look at these trees right here. You see it right here? These are two separate trees. But from this camera view, looking through my phone camera, there's no depth of field. And that's why we crash. That is why we crash. Because when we looking through our phone or our RC controller, the depth of field is gone. Let me see if I can move it some. You see right now, it's back. I know the space in between my trees. Because I'm not in that camera view no more. I'm in 3D view. A real person view where I can, like, you see how I'm moving around. When we're in real life, we may not be moving, but I can rotate my head left and right to give me a little depth perception. But when I go through my camera view, depth perception is gone out the window. Right here, you see I have two trees, but from this camera view, looking through my camera, the trees like they one entity. There's no space between them. No space at all. See, right when I go back to here, you see right here, the trees right there, there's that line. From this angle, I can't tell. But when I have my person, let me click on my little person. It's my little person. But my little person, you see they're going left to right. When I go from left, I look left. I look left right here, and I look right here. That helps me with my depth perception. But as I said, looking through this camera like that, I don't know how much space is this really. And that's, good people, why we crash our drones so much. When we're looking through the RC controller, looking through my phone, the world is flat like this. Just like this. And I can put right here, this is my phone. My phone view. This is how it looks in my phone. Or slash RC controller. The world is two-dimensional. All we have is length. All we have is length. And all we have is width. We don't have height. We don't have depth. Gone. All we have is length and width and no depth perception. So I hope, good people, by watching my little 3D view and from my camera view, my side view, you have an understanding now of why drones crash so much and why DJI say, okay, we gotta build that avoidance system, object avoidance, because too many people crashing their drones up and sending a drone back to us to repair. Our repair bill is going through the roof. So DJI and some of the others say, we gotta make up something to help these people stop crashing their drones when they're looking through to that phone or the RC controller, because the depth of field has been destroyed. And I just now thought of that today too, because I started to notice that. Like now, I'm still new to flying drones. I started flying it in December, and now it's, what is it, April? So let me see. January, February, March. 4 months I've been flying a drone, roughly. But that came to me when I was looking through my, for me, I have a Potentic Atom, SE and an Atom. When I was looking through that, my phone, I noticed now, I start to notice, hey, there's no depth perception, especially when it comes to trees. Especially when it comes to trees. And I may switch to that, the tree view too. Now I don't have no down view on my camera. Let me go to, let me see it. Yeah, let me see if I can go to the top view. See right here, the top view. When I have my drone, I'm coming down. The drone still don't tell me how close I am to the tree. I just, this is how it really look when I fly my drone, like that. I have to make a guess. As, okay, am I too close to that tree? I wish it did have, but still, if it did have some measurement tools for a tree, it's hard to tell because those little branches may be hard to detect by the sensor. Because you know, I even though I don't have a DJI, I know from what I heard, it's hard for object avoidance to pay attention to cables, which I should have put on here, you know, like them electrical cables, and the tree, those limbs on the trees, because it's so thin. So I think obstacle avoidance is made for more bulky objects like a human being, a brick wall, stuff that got some depth to it. If it's like a thin wire, a thin twig, obstacle avoidance won't see it. And it definitely probably won't see the top of this tree like this, because there's so much open space here. I know in my 3D Benjamin, but you know, like a real tree got so much open space, so it may be hard even for object avoidance to detect that until you right on top of it like this. So, that's it, my good people, of discovering why we usually crash our drones and why we need obstacle avoidance to help us with this two-dimensional rule where space is basically thrown, like right here, especially right here, the dimensions are thrown out the window from this view. Let me go to other views too, though. I'm doing the right view. Let me see front view. See? I still, no matter what view I have, I really can't see my spacing properly. Right here, that's like there's a couple, like 1 or 2 meters here. Let me try another view. What was that? I did right, I did back. See? Still, no matter what view I have this area right here. And we know from when we was looking at it from my view, it has some... All these trees are far apart. You know that all of them. Let me make a zoom around them. All of them, if it was in the real world, they're at least 5 meters apart from each other. All the trees are at least 5 meters apart. It's like there's a lot of open space here. But you can't see it from that particular camera view. I did the left. See, still that ugly, like they're touching right here. I did left and front. See, still touching there. I did every angle. Left, front. I did back and right. So that's basically my good people about why we usually crash our drones so much. Because looking through that RC controller, looking through the phone controller, our depth of field of an actual figure is gone. Now I can see when I'm approaching it. I can see when I'm approaching that, but the space here is so narrow, I really can't fully tell. So now I know why. Now I haven't crashed my drone much, even in my little 3 months. I still have crashed, but there was no major crash where I got changed propeller blades and all that. All right, I hope this helped you out. Until the next time, drone family, peace.